Hello everyone, welcome back. So today I'll be sharing with you this powerful all-in-one Cinematic 2 plugin that I've already created for you guys. Okay, before the start of everything, please remember to subscribe to my channel and like this video. And also, if you like these titles that I show you from the start of this, you know, tutorial and plugin sharing, just go to the link in the description. It'll direct you to the other videos where I've also created these titles for free, and you can just download and use them. I'm not going to show you over here because, you know, it's kind of boring to show it twice, but make sure just to check it out. And please remember to just comment in the comment section to tell me what you want to see next, and I'm gonna create a new plugin, say a transition plugin or an effect plugin to, you know, let you guys use for free. And first up, let me show you how to install this. After you've already unzipped the pack, just go to Go, Home, Movies, Motion Templates, and just paste the file LC Tools over here, and you should be able to see the all-in-one Cinematic tool in the subfolder. And just, you know, restart your Final Cut Pro, and it will be there in the effects column, and it should be there. If you're not seeing this, just drop a comment and I'm gonna help you to solve this problem. And let's move on to the applications. So for the application, it's actually pretty simple as well. So I'm gonna lengthen this first. So I'm just gonna drag this and drop it on the clip, and it's already automatically with a LUT applied. And if you're not seeing the LUT, you might need to download the LUT pack, and I'll just link the LUT pack in the description as well, or you just check out the other video introducing the LUT pack for you guys, which is also free. Go to the inspector over here, and for LUT, I'm just gonna choose none first. So the color change is actually to signal that this plugin is working successfully. And for you to have a cinematic screen, those CinemaScope, you just, you know, go to the top and find cinematic screen and just bring the opacity all the way to 100, and you should see two black bars. Just to show you clearer, yep, it's going to have two black bars. And then, for example, if you want to have grains, noisy grains, you just go to grain noise and just turn it up, and you can actually turn down the opacity. Once you play, it's going to have very noisy grain. And yep, if you like this, you can just keep it. If not, you can always go for the 60mm grains and just bring up the opacity. And once you play, it's going to have grains as shown, you know, in the introduction video. It's going to look pretty awesome. And of course, you can always have, you know, lens blur like this. And yep, and once you pump up the lens blur, it's going to be very blurry, but you can always just create a few keyframes. For example, create a keyframe here, and a few frames later, just pump up the volume and go back a few frames later to be zero, and just hit play. And this is like a very cinematic blurring effect. Of course, you can create few sets of these kind of keyframes to create a constant blurring and refocusing kind of effect. So of course, if you want to have a flickering effect, it's also possible. For me, I recommend to drag the flicker brightness amount to the left to be zero, and pump up the flicker variance, and then just hit play. Yep, this is like the cinematic effect. And of course, if you want to have a very highly saturated kind of a clip, you can always just, you know, pump up the saturation over here. You can desaturate it, of course, or this is to create a cinematic effect such as, you know, flashbacks and everything. If not, you can just pump it up to a very high value. And yep, this is just to add sort of a color to your clip. And of course, you can add scratches, see, yeah, film scratches, and this, you know, you actually can create a few keyframes to create a variance, like a changing value. Let me show you. Create a few keyframes and then come back here, and once you hit play, yep, this is the scratches. I don't really like this, so I'm not going to use that, but I'm gonna use another thing called hairs and dust. So this is, you know, to create those cinematic effect. It's not very clear because, you know, these scratches are not very, you know, obvious, but of course, you know, it should be, you know, kind of a good thing to have. And also there's going to be screen shake elements over here. You can change the jitter amount and variance. I suggest not to pump it up too much, and once you turn it on, it's like this. And if you want to make it a more dramatic one, you can just pump up the horizontal and vertical shake and pump up the shake layers as well. And it's going to be very, very shaky, but, you know, cinematic, so it's kind of good. Yep, and last but not least, there's going to have a vignette darken. So let me go to a brighter kind of a screen over here and turn off this cinematic screen. So the vignettes is going to look like this, and yep, it's not very obvious, but I think it's kind of very handy. And that's all for today's tutorial and plugin sharing. Please remember to subscribe and like this video, and I'm going to give you guys more and more plugins. And just to comment in the comment section to tell me what, you know, what you want to see for the next video in terms of new plugins, say transitions or new effects. And I'm gonna try my best to create for you guys, and you just can download for free and use them and improve your video qualities. And that's all. Bye bye.